Today, we close Severe Weather Awareness Week with information on flooding and flash flooding. The following information has been prepared by the National Weather Service Atlanta Forecast Office. Flash flooding and flooding events are nothing to fool around with. When you look at the last 30 years, flooding and flash flooding events result in an average of about $7.82 billion in damage every year and approximately 94 deaths per year. The state of Georgia is not a stranger to flooding events. The epic floods of September 2009 greatly impacted the metro Atlanta area, causing approximately $300 million in damage and killing 10 people. This event unfolded quickly and resulted from 15 to 20 inches of rain in a several county area. During these events is not the time to prepare. One of the first ways to prepare is to educate yourself on the differences in flooding terminology. A flood is the inundation of a normally dry area caused by rising water in an existing waterway, such as a river, stream, or drainage ditch. Flooding is a longer-term event than flash flooding and can last days or weeks. Now, a flash flood is a flood caused by heavy or excessive rainfall in a short period of time, generally less than 6 hours. They can also sometimes occur when no rain has fallen, as when a levee or dam has failed, or after a sudden release of water by debris or ice jam. A watch means that flash flooding or flooding is possible in or near the watch area. This means that the environment has all the ingredients necessary for a flash flood or flood to occur. A warning means that flash flooding or flooding is already occurring in the area or will be very soon. During a watch, you should stay aware of quickly changing conditions, and if you live in a low-lying area or near a river, stream, or dam, then you need to be making preparations to evacuate if necessary. During a warning, especially a flash flood warning, you should evacuate quickly. If not, the rapidly rising floodwaters could leave you trapped. The last place you want to be is on your roof, waiting for a boat or helicopter to take you to safety. From 1998 to 2011, an average of 57% of the flash flooding and flooding-related deaths each year were associated with vehicles. In 2011, that number was 63%. In the September 2009 event, 8 out of 10 deaths were vehicle-related. During a flooding or flash flooding event, if you're in your car, be sure to pay attention to blocked roads and barricades. Do not drive through standing water, and especially not in water where downed electrical or power lines are present. If the car stalls, leave it immediately and seek higher ground. And be especially cautious at night when it can be difficult to see the impact a flood or flash flood has had on the area. Often, drivers make the poor decision to proceed through a flooded road either because the vehicle in front of them makes it or because they think the water doesn't look too deep. This video from September 2009 shows cars ultimately making the right decision to turn around, don't drown. It only takes 18 inches of water to lift your car or SUV. Once your vehicle becomes buoyant, the water will easily push it sideways. Most vehicles will then tend to roll over, trapping those inside and washing them downstream. Floodwaters can also hide damage to the road, like in this picture. It's always safer to avoid the flooded road and find an alternate route. It is also important to go ahead and prepare yourself and your family for flooding or flash flooding at home as well. The first step is to determine if your home is in a high-risk flood zone. Use resources like the Georgia Flood Mapping Assessment and Planning Tool, available at www.georgiadfirm.com to assess your flood risk. If you're in a high-risk area, you are likely required to have flood insurance, and those near a high-risk area may decide flood insurance is a good investment. If in the high-risk area, be sure to keep extra supplies on hand like sandbags, trash bags, shovels, work boots, and gloves. Purchase a weather radio to monitor rapidly changing conditions. Assemble a disaster or ready kit, including food, clean water, medications, flashlights, first aid supplies, and other necessary items. Look for ready kit checklists online at ready.gov. Be sure you also plan at least 2 evacuation routes and inform all members of the family. Need additional information on flooding or other weather-related hazards? Be sure you see our website at weather.gov/Atlanta and go to our Severe Weather Awareness Week headline or contact us at the email shown here.